We are asked to write sigma notation, also referred to as summation notation, for the finite sum, then determine the sum. Let's first determine the pattern in the series. Notice 64 minus 8 equals 56. 56 minus 8 equals 48. 48 minus 8 equals 40. Remember, subtracting 8 is equivalent to adding negative 8. So because we are subtracting the same value each time to determine successive terms, or we can say because we are adding negative 8 each time to determine successive terms, this is an arithmetic series, and therefore we can use the arithmetic formulas shown here below to help us write the sum using sigma notation. Because the first term is 64, a sub 1 equals 64, the common difference d is negative 8, because the pattern is to subtract 8 each time or add negative 8. Notice how there's also a formula to determine the common difference d, given by a sub 1 minus a sub n minus 1, which means to determine the common difference d, we can take any term in the series and subtract the term before it. Notice 40 minus 48 is negative 8, and so is 48 minus 56, as well as 56 minus 64. And now we can use a sub 1 and d to determine the formula a sub n that will generate the terms of the series, where a sub n is equal to a sub 1, the first term of 64, plus the quantity n minus 1, times the common difference d, which is negative 8. Now we will simplify by distributing negative 8 and combining like terms. A sub n equals 64, and now we will distribute negative 8, so we have plus negative 8 times n, which is plus negative 8n, or just minus 8n, and then we have plus negative 8 times negative 1, which is positive 8, giving us plus 8. 64 plus 8 equals 72, a sub n equals 72 minus 8n. And now to write the sum using sigma notation, we have the summation, and then we'll use the variable n as the index. So we begin with n equals 1. The formula to generate the terms in the series is given by 72 minus 8n, and now we're left to determine the upper limit of the index, or the last value of n, which is the value of n that will generate the last term in the series, which is 16. To determine this value, we will set the formula 72 minus 8n equal to 16 and solve for n. So doing this, we have 72 minus 8n equals 16. Next step, subtract 72 on both sides. Simplifying, we have negative 8n equals 16 minus 72 is equal to negative 56. Last step to solve for n is divide both sides by negative 8. Simplifying, we have n equals negative 56 divided by negative 8 is equal to positive 7. The upper limit of the index, or the last value of n, is 7. And now we have the sum written using sigma notation. The second part of the question asks us to determine the sum of the series. And because we have an arithmetic series, we can use the formula for S sub n to help us determine the sum. Again, because there are 7 terms in the series, the sum is equal to S sub 7. As soon as we write S sub 7, we know n is equal to 7. So S sub 7 is equal to n divided by 2 is 7 divided by 2. Times the quantity a sub 1 plus a sub n is a sub 1 plus a sub 7, which is the sum of the first term and the last term, which in our case is 64 plus 16. Simplifying inside the parentheses, 64 plus 16 equals 80. This is equal to 7 halves times 80. Let's write 80 is 80 over 1. Before multiplying, we simplify. There's 1, 2, and 2, and 40 2s and 80, which gives us 7 times 40, which equals 280. The sum, S sub 7, equals 280. I hope you found this helpful.